All right, folks, Samori Benjamin here at Citi Field, and we have a special guest, former Met, Michael Conforto. And Michael, good to see you back here in Queens. And like, folks, I got a chance to meet Mike here when he first came up with the Mets in 2015, and that year they went to the World Series, so that was a special year. But Michael, welcome, man, welcome back.
Thank you, it's good to be back.
How does it feel just when you come back to Queens, Citi Field, where you began your career?
A lot of memories coming back, a lot of really good feelings. You know, obviously a World Series here, went to an All-Star game, went through a lot of ups and downs, met my wife here, you know, so there's just a lot that goes with coming out here to New York, and especially in this building, a lot of firsts, and a lot of love from the fans, and just a lot of great memories.
Yes, and I meant to mention in the intro, 2017 All-Star in Miami that year. Now, Mike, first, I'm interested when you were coming up as a kid. I know you're from Oregon, and I remember you were in the Little League World Series and all that, really cool. But how did you get into baseball in Oregon growing up?
You know, it was just one of the many sports that I played growing up. I played basketball, soccer, football, and baseball, and I took a special liking to hitting home runs, and I was a big fan of Ken Griffey Jr., wanted to swing just like him, and you know, so that was kind of the first time I really fell in love with baseball, and I never thought I would end up in New York, but getting drafted by the Mets, probably the best thing that ever happened to me, and you know, they gave me my shot and started my career, and here we are now.
Yeah, so I know you've probably been asked about it a few times, Little League and the Little League World Series, but that very cool, because all of us grew up playing Little League. We all grew up playing in that tournament, or dreaming to make it to Williamsport. You actually did, and had a chance to be on a big stage at a young age. So what do you remember just about those times?
I mean, that was probably where I realized that, you know, it was something that I wanted to do, and kind of, you know, focus my energy on doing everything I could to be a professional baseball player. Played on TV, met a bunch of kids from around the world, you know, made some great friendships, and it's such a great tournament. It's such a great exposure for those young kids to show what they can do, to just kind of instill some passion and some values of hard work, and, you know, at a really young age, and kind of show them that you can do this, and you know, the dream is attainable for sure. So very cool.
And I know you went to Oregon State, but before I get to that, I'm just curious, as a kid, you know, in Oregon, did the Portland Trailblazers, and were you a Trailblazers fan?
Well, I went to college in Oregon. I grew up in Seattle.
Grew up in Seattle,
yeah,
okay.
Sonics fan.
Nice, man, nice. Yeah. Seattle, yeah, Sonics, a lot of really good team. Gary Payton, mm-hmm. Sean Kemp. So, of course, Ken Griffey Jr., that makes sense. And, yeah, I always tell people that as a fan growing up, I grew up here in New York, a Yankee fan, and hardest loss I took as a fan in any sport is 95. Yankees lost to Seattle in 95, first round. That was devastating, man. And I actually went to Seattle last year for the first time for the All-Star game, so
yeah,
that was really cool. Now, in Oregon State, you made the, you all were in the College World Series as well, mm-hmm. right? Yeah, so now, how was your time in the Pac-10 playing against those teams, and then you all make it to the College World Series?
It was great. You know, I definitely became a more polished player in college. You know, I owe a lot to the coaching staff that was there at the time. Coach Casey, awesome coach. You know, the College World Series was incredible. You know, I was lucky enough to be one of the few guys to play in all three of them. Haven't won one yet, so that's the next box to check. But just, you know, college baseball is such an awesome game. It's so emotional. You know, when you watch college players, they leave everything out there. They don't play every day. They play weekend series. So there's so much buildup and so much anticipation. It's such a team game. And so it's just, it's a very pure form of baseball that, you know, kind of shaped me into the player that I was, that I am.
Now, what year was it again that the Mets drafted you?
2014.
Wow. And just within a year, you were in the big leagues with the Mets. So what do you remember first about being drafted by the Mets in 2014?
Getting a call from the New York media, or, you know, our media director, putting me in with a presser with the New York media. I got a text from David Wright, and then just kind of a whirlwind of emotions, being drafted by a major league team and getting my start in pro baseball. So that's kind of the first thing I remember, celebrating with my friends and family in college.
And that's cool because a lot of people have to spend a few years in the minor league, so you get through it very fast. And I remember 2015, the Mets had not had a good season in years, and the fans really wanted the team to be good that year. And midway through the season, they were right there in the race, but offense was struggling mightily, and that was all the talk. And then they brought you up, and they traded for Juan Uribe, I remember, around the same time. Then like a week or two later, they get Cespedes in a trade, and then the team takes off. So what do you remember about your first being called up in July, I believe it was, and then just that two-month run you all had into the playoffs?
An absolute run we went on. First of all, getting called up from Double A, call my parents, tell them my heart's beating out of my chest. I went 0-for-4 in my first game, remember that very well, 4-for-4 in my next game. Then we go get Uribe, we get Cespedes, we go get Kelly Johnson, Tyler Clifford, some other pieces, and just, Cespedes got hot, he carried us. I played my role with a decent rookie year, and then we just kept it rolling through the playoffs. Daniel Murphy carries us through, a good chunk of the playoffs, and just an awesome experience for me.
Yeah, I still remember that first weekend series to get the Nationals here, and the ballpark was rocking, and that was the loudest. That was the first time really I'd heard the ballpark rock since the Mets got to Citi Field, and you all really had just that great run. And World Series, I know you all lost, but it was electric in here. What was it like to be able to play in the World Series so young?
It was awesome. It was dreamlike. I didn't expect to be there, but it was a dream come true. And I wish we could have finished it out, but it's kind of just the way it goes. And I always have those memories to look back on.
All right, two more for you. I appreciate it. Before you get ready for the face your old team. Now, 2017, you had a big year, and made the All-Star team. I believe you got hurt before that year finished, right? Yeah, hurt your shoulder. But you had that All-Star season. How was it for you to be able to be a part of the All-Star team in Miami 2017? That was a really fun All-Star weekend.
It was great. It was a blast. It was awesome to meet, some of my, the guys I looked up to the most, the Buster Posey's, the Trouts, just so much talent, so many great players there, being such a young kid, just getting to rub shoulders with those guys was really awesome.
The last one for you. Now, Jess, you finished up your Mets career. You were here for a few years, and then you moved on. But Jess, what comes to mind when you think of Jess, your time here in New York, and how has life been for you on the West Coast with San Fran?
It's been great. I definitely miss the big city. I miss my teammates, the guys that are still over there. Some of the coaches, some of the people who work around this ballpark. I ended up getting married, having a baby boy. I have a 5-month-old baby boy, and so life is definitely different now. But I've made a new home in San Francisco, and I'm really enjoying it. So. I got to thank everybody who helped me create my career here and kind of on to the next phase here, but I'll always miss playing here in New York.
Okay, well, Mike, congrats to you on becoming a father, and we always love seeing you back here in New York, and good luck tonight against your former team.
Thank you very much.
All right, buddy. All right, folks. 2017 All-Star, we're back.